press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Okay, children. So, the past few sessions, theory part of the motion is straight line. Most of that we have done with. So, like we have started with basic parameters for the straight line motion, like path length, distance, speed, velocity, acceleration, uniform acceleration, non-uniform acceleration, related graphs. Along with that, we started with kinematic equations for the bodies moving with uniform acceleration. Equations we have derived, and then some here and there some applications on equations of motion we have studied, graphical problems we have studied, and then we entered into motion A, vertical motion. Vertical motion under two headings we have studied. What are those? One is freely falling body, the other one is vertically projected body. And then finally, in the previous session, relative velocity concept we have studied. So these are all till now all the points which got completed. If you are thorough enough with these things for board exam perspective, that is more than enough. And I hope you got some knowledge related to some a few related terms like related to velocity, accelerated bodies. And meanwhile, we have discussed about non-uniform acceleration, how to solve the problems on them based on the calculus based problems also we have studied in between. So till now, what the knowledge you have gained, it is not only applicable for this particular chapter itself. It is extended, this knowledge what you gained is going to be extended in more of the concepts in the coming days. What are all you are going to dealt with plus one and plus two syllabus. Okay, here and there will be making use of all the points what you have studied about making use of kinematic equations or finding out the displacement, velocity, time or any of the relations among them. It's not limited to this. Beyond that also we have studied, right? I'll extend my this vertical, in a straight line motion. I'll extend my explanation even for a few more points where you need to be thorough with. This is purely for competitive what I am going to discuss today. Competitive, it's not like only this much is competitive. We have already learnt all the concepts, includes that even for competitive. Along with that, in addition, some more shortcuts which you have to remember, the way how they are going to ask the problems. We'll take some concepts over there and I'll explain them. While solving the problems with some assignment sheets, you should be able to recall each and all what we have studying today. And that will help you a lot by the time when we are going to discuss about the numericals even. Okay, so kind of applications we'll study. I'll start with now the application, like I'm going to have a body which is going to be dropped from certain height. I'm going to say a body is going to be dropped from a height h. Told you these are all applications related to the motion in a straight line. It's not like it is only for this particular thing. In turn, we can make them note. You just make a note of them, all of them, as points wise you can make a note. Okay, so the first one is we are going to study, like a body is going to be dropped from certain height. At the same instant, another body is going to be thrown vertically up in the same straight line path itself. Means another body is going to be thrown vertically up with a velocity of u. I'm going to drop a body from certain height. At the same time, another one is going to be thrown just above this, where you are going to drop, no, just above this one only I'm going to throw the ball. With what velocity? U. We are going to throw the body up with a velocity of how much it is? U. Now, when and where they'll meet, they'll ask for it. This is a dropped body. Dropped means its initial velocity is how much? Zero. The one which body which has been dropped is having a velocity, initial velocity zero. The one which it is going to be thrown up is supposed to have a velocity of how much it is? U. When and where they will meet, they will ask. How to solve for it? If you want to write the question tag for it, you can add ma. A body is dropped from certain height. A body is dropped from height h,
from a height h simultaneously another body is thrown up with velocity u just above it means what? Just above it, this what? Above this one we are going to throw the body vertically up simultaneously, both. By the time when it is dropped, this is going to be thrown up, both are going to happen at the same instant. Then both will meet after a time off. After a time off, how much they'll ask, or displacement they may ask, or anything. First, let us find out the time after which they are going to meet, and then we'll see how we need to write for the problem here. So now, let's say both has travelled for a time of t seconds. Meanwhile, they are going to meet. I'm going to say, meanwhile, it travelled a displacement of s1, and it travelled a displacement of s2. What is the total distance both bodies have been travelled here? S1 plus s2. It should be equals to what? H. Okay. So here, for a dropped body, distance travelled will be equals to what? My S1. How to find out? That's what, for this purpose only we have studied those equations of kinematics. For freely falling body, what is the displacement after a time of t seconds? We have written S equals to half gt square. Okay, so you have to make use of it. S equals to half gt square. This is what? Displacement of what? First body. What is the displacement of the second body? For vertically projected body, what is the equation, displacement equation we have written? S equals to ut minus half gt square. I hope you have remembered. For a body thrown up, what is the displacement equation we have to write? S2 equals to ut minus half gt square. Ut minus half gt square. But what is the total distance it has been now? S1 plus S2 equals to what? H. S1 plus S2 equals to what? H. So add these two equations, what you'll get? Minus half gt square, plus half gt square, they'll get cancelled. What else is remaining now? Ut. So that means I can write directly, I'll write, see that substitution. Ut equals to H. From this what I can write? T, it will be equals to H by U. What is the time after which both the bodies are going to move? H by U. If you remember that shortcut, it will be very useful. Useful in the sense, no need of solving this entire problem over there. Directly we can solve for the problem. At what height they are going to meet? First solve for T equals to H by U. This T value, how much you will get? The time, substitute in this equation. Ut minus half gt, they will give U value. Right? So you have to substitute the time, whatever you got, into this equation. If you substitute, you can find out at what height both the bodies are going to meet, can be found easily using this relation. I hope you got this point, right? A body has been dropped from certain height and another is thrown vertically up at the same instant. See, these are happening at the same instant. So dropping and throwing up are at same instant at t equals to 0. Both have been met after some time means, this for travelled for t means even this also in the same time only, you know, it travelled, both are meeting in the sense. That's why you have taken both have travelled for a time of t seconds, and then finally t equals to what? H by u. This formula is very, very important, which you have to remember with. So, and how to find out when and where? When means H by u, where? S2. This S2 you have to substitute for the value of time, whatever you got the value, right? Substitute into this equation. By the time first a dropped body has traveled, how much distance means, how to find out? Half gt square you find. After traveling a distance of this one, you have to find it out. Or if you from the ground it is at a height of, means S2, which you have to find it out. So this is a problem related to the body dropped, the other one is going to be thrown, relation among them. So next, I'm going to extend this problem for one more here now. Instead of a body is dropped, I'm going to say that even this body is also thrown down with a speed u. Now this is second problem which you have to learn with. A body is going to be thrown down with a speed u. another is thrown up with a speed u. What is the time after which both the bodies are going to meet? A body is thrown down with speed u, from a height h. Simultaneously, another body is thrown up with velocity u just above it. Then both will meet after a time of question mark. I hope you got this point again. Just a small correction I have made. What is that? Instead of a freely dropping, I am going to throw the body down with speed u. What is the speed with which it is thrown? U. At the same instant, another body is going to be thrown up with speed u. Then both will meet after a time of how much? Means substitute S1. Now you tell me what is the equations I need to write for S1 and S2. First I will rub S1. What is the equation? Freely falling means S1 is half gt square. But thrown down means you are giving some initial velocity, it is not 0. Means I have given that equations also yesterday, or sorry, in some other session when we have discussed, we have given that. That is ut plus half gt square. Ut plus half gt square is what? Displacement travelled by the first body which is thrown down with speed u. So now you talk something about, and the same S2 will be same, the one which is thrown upright travels ut minus half gt square displacement. So now talking to this displacement, S1 plus S2 is no doubt it will be equals to what? H. So now talk, total distance is what? H they have travelled. S1 is ut plus half gt square, S2 is ut minus half gt square. Adding these two, what you will get? Minus half gt square plus half gt square, they will get cancelled. Ut plus ut is what? 2ut. So therefore, S1 plus S2 is what? 2ut equals to h, or the value of t, it will be equals to what? H by 2u means both of them will meet after a time of h by 2u seconds. That's the meaning of it. H by 2u, this is the time. What is the distance they have travelled means? Substitute whatever the value of t you got, you can substitute S1 if you want, after what distance from thrown body or at what height. Means for S2 you have to substitute for the values of time. They will give h and u values will be given in this problem. They are given the value of h as well as u values will be given in these problems. Then how you need to solve? This is the method how you have to follow for solving the problem. Instead of u and u, they are given this is u1 and this is u2. Just a small correction here, u1 and u2. Then what happens? This will become, instead of 2ut, you have to write what? U1 plus u2 into t. Then this problem will become h by u1 plus u2 will be the time it takes to both of them to meet together. Okay. So this is about the concept related to the problem related to what? how, when and where they are going to meet, when they have been thrown on, when they have been whenever it is dropped or thrown, these two points or conditions you have to remember related to this problem. Short way, you can remember the formulas: h by u in case of a dropped body, h by 2u in case of a body thrown down with a speed of u. Next. Okay. Next application. These are all some tricks you can say in vertical motion. As it is, you just remember the values. No need of any mathematical calculations required. While solving for these problems, when you are going to make use of these tricks or tips, you can say, like, a body is thrown up. Somewhere exactly at half the maximum height, what will be its speed, they will ask. This is h max by 2. Okay. Or I will say, instead of max again, h by 2 I will say. Maximum height what the body can reach is what? H. Then this is the height what? H by 2. At this point, what is the speed? And again, at 3 h by 4, at a distance of how much it is? 3h by 4, what will be the speed? And at a height h, you know what is the speed at height h? At height h, speed equals to what? 0. This point you know. And at a height of exactly half the maximum height, speed will be equals to how much? How to solve means? You take this velocity as v and this initial speed is what? U. Our intention is to write the speed in terms of this initial velocity u. Okay. Formula is what? V square equals to u square minus 2 into g into h is nothing but how much here? H by 2. But you know the formula for maximum height is how much? U square by 2g. I hope you have remembered the relation. So this 2, they will get cancelled. So therefore, this is u square minus g into, this is in place of h you can write u square by 2g, formula which you have to remember with g, they will get cancelled. Then I can write this one as v square equals to 1 minus 1 by 2. See, u square minus u square by 2 means u square by 2. Or the value of speed, v equals how much? U by root 2. This is the speed. Shortcut you have to remember. No need of solving this entire formula. If you are aware of this, remember this. Whatever I have mentioned now about the speed at half the maximum height, once again I am going to recall the same formula when we are going to study in motion a plane. So that will be very handy for you if you remember this. This calculation can be avoided if you remember this formula. Okay. So wherever it is necessary, the body is thrown up at half of the maximum height, what will be its speed? U by root 2. Similarly, where its speed is half of the initial speed. Initial speed is u, know? Half the initial speed means what? U by 2. At what height? Means at a height of 3h by 4, its speed will be u by 2. Just keep this point in mind. V equals to u by 2 where? At h equals to 3/4 of the maximum height. Standard formula which you have to remember. They ask in future coming classes, work energy, power and all. A body is thrown vertically up at with a speed of some u, initial velocity something they will give. At 3/4 of the maximum height reached by the body, what will be its kinetic energy? Means kinetic energy means half mv square we know. Means you need to know the value of v at that point. So then half into m into v square means u by 2 whole square. They are given with what speed it is thrown. Thrown with 3 meter per second. Substitute for the value of velocity at 3/4 of the maximum height. Then you can solve for the value. Okay. Or what is the potential energy when its speed is u by 2? Its speed is u by 2 at what height? 3h by 4. Then maximum potential energy formula is what? M into g into h. H is how much here? Means 3h by 4, 3 capital H by 4. So like that also, these 2 points are to remember. So this is one thing. As a third point, you can note down this one, whichever you have written, right? As a third point, you can note it down. I hope you can remember these two. What is this? Speed at half the maximum height and speed at 3/4 of the maximum height. You can write down these two formulas. What is that? At half the maximum height u by root 2 and 3/4 of the maximum height u by 2. Remember these two points. Next, fourth point you make a note. Next point. This is very important. See, and a body is thrown with certain velocity like this. No doubt this is the speed with which it has been thrown. Means at the point of projection, what is the speed? What is the point of projection? This is the point where I am going to throw it up. Plus u it is. Okay. Plus u is the speed where it has, with which it has been thrown vertically up. No doubt it reaches the maximum height here, speed will become 0. Meanwhile, when it is coming down, once again when it reaches the ground, what will be its speed? Means minus u. Remember this. Speed at that point remains same. When it is moving up at this point of projection, if speed is u, at the same point after it has come down, right, what will be its speed? Minus u. If you solve also, you will get the same thing. The trick you will just remember. Not only at this point, somewhere a point P I will take in its path. When it is moving up, if its speed is, speed at point P is v, if I say, when it is moving up, right? At the same time when it is moving down, at the same point P, what is the speed means? Minus u. Velocity is what? Minus u. Minus indicates opposite direction. Magnitude of speed remains same at that point.
What is that? Magnitude of speed at that point, it remains same. I hope you got this point, right? So once again, I'll repeat. A body is thrown with certain velocity at all the points when it is moving in its path, at all the points when it is moving in its path in upward direction. With what speeds it will move at corresponding points, it is going to move with the same speed when it is moving in the downward direction. Okay, so at corresponding points, at point P, when it is moving up, if its speed is V, when it is coming down also its speed will be V. That negative sign indicates it is in the opposite direction, that's all. If it is thrown up with speed U, what is the speed when it comes back to the same point of projection? U itself. Magnitude of velocity is U, that is nothing but speed. What is the velocity means? Minus U, you have to say. Direction you have to include when you speak about the velocity. So two crucial points you have to remember. Now see how I'll make use of this particular topic or this particular point to solve certain kind of problems. What kind of problems? We have studied about top of the tower problem, we have studied, I hope you have remembered. Okay, now I told you, even I would have discussed one point I told at the time. Now I will discuss that. What is that? A body is thrown up with the speed U from where? Top of the tower of height h. From which height? H. Now no doubt it reaches the maximum height, and once again it reaches where? Bottom of the tower. Bottom of the tower. They have given that it is going to hit the ground with a speed of V equals to n times of initial velocity. What they have given in the question? A body is dropped, or sorry, a body is projected up from a height of h, from a top of the tower of height h with a speed u, right? And I told you this is top of the tower problems, means we are not well on the tower there, and we are not well on the middle of the tower, we are at the edge of the tower. All the problems, a body projected from the top of the tower means immediately it should come into your mind that it is projected somewhere at the edge of the tower. Means their intention is not to talk something about body is going to fall back onto the tower there, foot of the tower it is going to reach. If speed with which it is going to hit the foot of the tower is n times u, then find the value of the v, n they will ask there. Then what is the value of n they are going to ask? I hope you got this question. What is that? Should I want to give the question tag for this again? If it is so, note down, like if a body is thrown up, if a body is thrown or projected, anything, body is thrown up with velocity V, velocity U from top of a tower of height H, from top of a tower of height h, then if it hits the ground, it hits the ground with v equals to n times of u, then find the value of n. That's what the question they are asking here. What is this? I hope you can see that clearly. If a body is thrown up with velocity u from where? From top of the tower of height h, then if it is going to hit the ground, if it hits the ground with a speed what? N times of u, then what is the value of n? Generally, if you want to view this complication, it is what I can say here is, see, no doubt it is going to move up. By the time when it is coming down, exactly at this point, what is the speed it is supposed to have? By the time when it is coming down, its speed at this point will be equals to how much? U itself, but in the opposite direction. Speed will be equals to what? U, but in the opposite direction, minus U, let it be. Okay, so why, according to this point which we have studied, the same concept it is. Okay, so that's why. By the time when it is moving up, if its speed is u at this point, at the same point its speed will be equals to what? U. Now for this journey you apply the equations. For this journey, see, it is like thrown down with speed u, moving down with acceleration equals to what? Plus g. Initial velocity is u, final velocity is what? V equals to n times of u. What is the distance traveled is how much here? H, in the downward direction, right? Distance traveled is equals to what? H. You know this relation, V square equals to U square plus 2AS. Use this relation. What you will get? V is nothing but what? N times of U whole square equals to, this is U square plus
2 into g into h. In place of as I have written gh. Solve for the values now. What you will get? Implies n square u square, or I will take this u square to the other side, it will become what? N square, or I think wait, u square equals to u square plus 2gh, or the value of n it will be equals to what? N it will be equals, or n square value it will be equals to 1 plus 2gh divided by u square. This is the value of n square. Dividing by u square, you will get what? N square equals to 1 plus 2gh by u square. In this problem, it's not like always, n means root of this value. If you take, you will get the value. Nothing to bother. If you get till there, it is enough. Then from there, n is nothing but root of this value, 1 plus 2gh divided by u square. See, in this problem, it's not like they are going to ask always the n value. Few times they'll give, what is the velocity of projection? They'll ask like this. A body is thrown up with a speed of certain value. If when it reaches the ground, it is going to hit the ground with a speed of 10 meter per second, means v value they have given 10. They are asking to find out what? U. Then you have to substitute into this equation. What is that? V square equals to u square plus 2gh. V they have given, u supposed to find, a is nothing but g, s is nothing but h they will give. The body is thrown up from the top of a tower of height 100 meters with certain speed. It reaches the foot of the tower with a speed of 20 meter per second. Then what is the speed with which the body is going to be thrown up, they'll ask. Then you have to solve for this kind of problem. I hope you got this. One application where you can make use for problem related to velocity is how they are going to be varied from one point to other point in case of vertical motion. You just remember, in the same point if I ask, of course you have not learned that point, that is about momentum. What is that? Momentum. Change in momentum of a projectile during flight. You know, momentum means in your schooling, you might have studied in your basic schooling, what is that? Momentum means product of mass and velocity is nothing but what? Momentum. Product of mass and velocity is momentum. Change in momentum means initial momentum when it is thrown up, how much it is? Mu. By the time when it reaches the ground, what is the momentum? Minus mu. Why? U is nothing but in the opposite direction. Change in momentum means what? Delta P during flight, they will ask for it. Pf minus Pi will be equals to, Pf is how much? Minus mu minus Pi is what? Mu. That's why change in momentum during time of flight of the projectile will be equals to minus 2mu. Very, very important formula which you have to remember. What is this? Change in momentum. Change in momentum of the projectile during flight, or during time of flight. During time of flight. During time, change in momentum of the projectile during time of flight is what? Minus 2mu. Magnitude of change in momentum means 2mu you can write. Change in momentum during time of flight of the projectile is what? Minus 2mu. Important formula. Okay. At the same time, change in momentum during ascent means initial momentum is mu. Final momentum is what? Zero. So that means 0 final minus initial is what? Minus mu. Minus mu. Then change in momentum during ascent, time of ascent means minus mu. During time of flight, change in momentum is minus 2mu with a negative sign. Just keep this point in mind. So you can add for this point also. And next, see. Very interesting question I am going to ask Dale. Meanwhile, I am going to wrap. I will ask the question. Just think of the question, what exactly it is. See, I am having a thin paper, almost weightless in one hand, and in the other hand, I am having a 5 kg stone. What I am considering? One is a thin paper of weightless, almost it is of negligible weight, you can say. Negligible weight I have taken. And another one is 10 kg stone I am going to hold in the hand. One is what? 10 kg stone. The other one is thin piece of paper. I am going to drop both of them from the same height. Both of them are going to be dropped from same height.
which is going to reach the ground first? One is 10 kg stone, another one is what? Thin piece of paper. Okay, so if both are dropped from same height, which one is going to reach the ground first? Obviously, we'll say like stone will reach the ground first, rather than thin piece of paper, we'll say. Why? Because we'll experience that. Why we'll experience means we are in environment, earth's environment it is. Means what? Air resistance do included in these conditions. Air resistance, if it is included, what happens? Weight of the body is going to be deferred. So if I want to write an equation for that particular condition of what will be the acceleration or velocity, if mass of the bodies are going to be considered, means loss of motion to be some points related to the force, you need to have an idea. So that we'll discuss once again in loss of motion chapter. I am going to discuss that, where the teacher will discuss, right? What happens if air resistance is going to be included, what it is going to happen, we'll study there. So now I told you throughout kinematics, when we are studying only motion of the body under pure gravity, we are studying pure gravity in the sense we are nothing bother, or we are not bothered about all the air resistance there. If it is dropped, I told you two bodies are dropped from certain height, which one will reach the ground first? Means we need to find out what is the time taken by them to reach the ground first. We have one formula for dropped body. What is the time taken to reach the ground? T equals to root of 2h by g. I asked you to remember. Hope you have remembered the value. Okay. So T equals what? Root of 2h by g. Now height is same from both the bodies which they have been dropped, right? One is 10 kg stone, the other one is what? Piece of paper, a small piece of paper I am having. Both have been dropped from same height. Both are dropped from same height. Gravity, this is same for both the bodies. For both the bodies, it is same. G value will be same. H is same, G is same. Then both are going to reach the ground in same time. This is very important bit they are going to ask. A thin piece of paper, a heavy weight like 5 kg stone or 10 kg stone, both are going to be dropped from same height above the ground in gravity, then both will reach the ground in the same time. Time it has taken to reach the ground is what? For both of them, it takes the same time. If it falls in 10 seconds, even 10 kg stone also falls in 10 seconds itself. Okay, na? So this is the point related to what? this is what time taken by the freely falling body is independent of the mass. Independent of mass, whether it is heavier mass or lighter mass, if I am going to drop, both will take the same time to reach the ground. So that's the point you have to remember related to freely falling body and the time it is going to take. And you should not think in your visualization that I am going to drop a stone on paper, obviously stone will fall faster, you'll think. Why generally in our atmosphere stone will fall faster means, see, weight mg is trying to pull in the downward direction, but friction will be there. What is that? Frictional force called air resistance, you can say. Net force on this one will be equals to ma. So ma is equals to mg minus frictional force. Our acceleration, it will be equals to how much now? Acceleration is g minus, I told you this point I will discuss in loss of motion, but still you remember here itself. Acceleration, it will be equals to what? G minus f by m. Now more the negative value, lesser will be the acceleration of the ball, of that body. Lesser this value, f by m ratio is less, meaning is what? G minus smaller value, obviously this ratio, acceleration is going to be more. Now you come back to this point of acceleration is more, means that will reach us the ground first. Keep this point in mind. In place of g, we'll get for massive particles, or you can say if air resistance is included, air resistance in brackets F, I have taken F is included for the motion, is included for the motion, then what is the acceleration? Acceleration will be equals to g minus F divided by M. Now mass is to be considered. when if I'm going to include the air resistance. If air resistance also if it is taken, then the value of mass do plays a role. More the mass, see this ratio now, this is very important, this is crucial. More is the mass, lesser is this F by M value. F by M value is less means this difference is going to be more. Okay, G minus smaller value will be bigger. Okay, instead of that, if mass is less, like a thin paper if I taken, mass is less, if mass is less, F by M ratio is going to be more. Smaller value in the denominator, so that fraction is going to be more, right? So if F by M value is more, then G minus bigger value, then obviously you are going to have what? Smaller value, or acceleration is less. So this is a point which you have to consider. Hence, if I will write see here itself, if M1 is greater than M2, mass of first body is greater than mass of the second body, in this condition, M1 means what? How mass is related with acceleration means according to this relation we have written. How means this is in accordance with this relation. How this free body diagram, learn in laws of motion chapter again in depth about all the points. Just have an idea. If more the mass, right, what more the mass, this ratio is less, hence acceleration will be more. If M1 is greater than M2, then acceleration is greater, A1 is greater than A2. If mass is more, then its acceleration is going to be more. Now you think of thin paper and one more is what? 10 kg stone. Which is having more mass? 10 kg stone will be have heavier mass. Hence, heavier mass will have acceleration more. Hence, it will reach the ground first. If air resistance is included, if I am going to include the air resistance, massive particle will reach early compared to the lighter particle. Understood? You just have an idea related to how this time on, now you tell me what is the time taken to reach the ground means, time taken t, it will be equals to root of 2h by, in place of g what I need to write, g minus f by m, g minus f by m, this is the formula for what, time taken by a freely falling body to reach the ground in the presence of air resistance. What is this f means? Air resistance they will give. How much is the resistance offered by the air or atmosphere present in the above the surface of the earth, right? How much is the air resistance that is going to be acted means F. Mass is the dropped mass, how much it is, M value we are aware. Then we can solve for the value. This is how we need to find out for some point related to what? Present in the presence of air resistance, how it varies the time taken, and in the absence of air resistance, if there is no air resistance, if only under gravity if the body is going to be dropped, so then what is the time taken? Time taken mean it takes both of them is going to take the same time in the absence of what? Air resistance. Now if I say okay, air resistance is also not there, I'm going to drop a body from certain height in gravity free region. In which region I'm going to drop? Gravity free region. Gravity free region means gravity free region. What is the meaning of this point? Gravity free region means what? Acceleration due to gravity will be zero. Gravity free region, or you can also use some more terminology while solving the problem, they will say like acceleration due to gravity ceases to act. Acceleration due to gravity, acceleration due to gravity ceases to act. See this terminology. What is that? Ceases to act. Acceleration due to gravity ceases to act. See this terminology, ceases to act, wherever you will see, there the value of G equals to what? Zero. That is G equals to zero. You just remember this terminology. Now you tell me in these two conditions, if acceleration due to gravity ceases to act all of a sudden on the earth, for example, all of a sudden G value is not there, let me say. So now if I am going to drop a body, how much time it takes to reach the ground? How much time it takes to reach the ground? T equals to root of 2h by G. G value is 0, na? Anything by 0 is what? Infinity. Time taken to reach the ground is infinity. What does this mean? If I drop this duster here, it will reach the ground after infinite time, means what? it will never reaches the ground. If you leave this chalk here, this chalk supposed to be present there itself, after some infinite time also it won't reaches the ground. After a long period of time, if you see, it will be there itself. If you jump, it will be there in air, there itself. You will never fall down. When acceleration due to gravity ceases to act, then G value will be zero, then the body will be at rest, you can say. Or if it is already moving with uniform speed, for example, see one more problem related in continuation for this ceases to act condition. I'll just put one more equation out there. What is that? A body has been dropped from certain height. It traveled for a time of t seconds. What is the time it has been traveled? T seconds. After it has been traveled for a time of t seconds, acceleration due to gravity ceases to act. Now you see here, the body has dropped from certain height, no problem, right? Now it traveled for a time of t seconds. After t seconds, acceleration due to gravity ceases to act. What is nature of motion of the body? Further they will ask. It is falling down, no doubt, initially above the ground I have dropped. By the time, right, it after a time of t seconds, what is happening for the entire this region? G equals to zero. That's what acceleration due to gravity ceases to act after it has been fallen for a time of t seconds. Means by this time, what is the speed it's supposed to have? It is dropped initially. Vu equals to zero. V equals to what? U plus atr gt will get here. Speed of the particle after a time of t seconds is what? Gt. When it is moving down from here on, see what happens. Will it be at there rest there itself? Earlier I told that if I leave it, it will be there itself. Why? I'm not giving any initial velocity. If I go into throw it and leave it, right, what happens? It moves continuously with uniform speed. Here also, by the time it has completed a time of t seconds, it continues to move with a speed of how much it is? Gt. Throughout this distance, remaining distance, it traveled with a speed of what? Gt. Right, gt means g value earlier, right? How much it is? 9.8 into for what time? They'll give. Then you can substitute, you'll get the value of v with which it will move. And from here on, acceleration is zero. It is moving with what? Uniform speed of v. Whatever the v value you'll get, that we have to substitute and you have to solve for the rest of the problem. So this is one typical problem related to acceleration due to gravity ceases to act. Means how to consider the problems on them. This is a tricky one which you have to learn with. Next, okay, so time is 5:00. So I hope you are done with the session today. I'll wind up for today's session. Almost we have done with that. Just recall with all the points what we have studied in the today's session. For the competitive perspective, some examples we have studied, some more examples and some more problems I'll give once again in the next session also. We'll continue them. I'll give with some more applications related to vertical motion as well as related problems or some tricky things what we have studied for today in the session, right? In the same way we'll discuss. And the points which we have studied, right, you'll come to know, or you'll come to know the use of those things when you supposed to start the problems. Numericals when you start doing, right, particularly for a competitive end when you have started doing, then you'll come to know the use of all the points which we have studied. So that will help you a lot. I hope you got all the points for today's session. I'm going to wind up for it and we'll see the remaining things in the next session then. Fine. Thank you.